can perforate the vagina and go intra-abdominal. So this is dangerous for this wrong technique. So when you introduce the catheter forward, please stop and try to find the external cross. When it touches the catheter, start to hold it upon the catheter. So this is the technique or the correct manner for passing the catheter into the cervix and start to make a version of the two valvulates. Then introduce the catheter at first upwards to avoid the pelvic heel, the scale arch. Then forward, progress forward. And your right hand is touching the, is holding the cervix through the rectum. When the catheter start to touch the so after introduction of the catheter at first upwards, then downward and forward, then you touch the external os. When you touch the external os, stop. And then start to bring the cervix upon the catheter to introduce it into the catheter. So in this manner, the cervix has been introduced, the catheter has been introduced into the cervix. So this, you can make this correct or judge its correct position by this thumb finger to go around the catheter and be sure that it is inside the cervix. So the wrong procedure, as you will see in the leaflet, is that you introduce the catheter and then start to introduce the catheter forward and through the folds of the vagina. This is wrong because you may make perforation. This is the wrong technique. Make perforation of the vagina. And at the same time, you will not go direct to the cervix. Palpation of the nerve differs in its technique from that of the cow. Because the genitalia of the male, as you see here, the two uterine horns are nearly in the same length as the uterine body. And these two uterine horns and the body are handled in the sublumbar region of the abdomen. And also here, the cervix is not so rigid or hard consistency like the kettle. So the guide for me in rectal palpation of the nerve, we take it to the right oval. So I introduce my hand forward here in the sublumbar region and try to hold the oval. Then be sure that this is exactly, or this is sure that this is the ovary from palpation, or just to manipulate it. And then proceed from the ovary down to the right wall, then to the... The technique in the nerve differs from that of cutting. We didn't try to find or calculate the cervix because it could not be recognized. It is very flabby and not of hard consistency. So two horns and the two ovaries are handled here in the sublumbar region. So I introduced my hand. Then I hold first the left ovary. So I hold the left ovary, estimate or diagnose its size, and show, see the ovulation fossa or depression. Then proceed downward. This is the ovary. I must be sure that this is the ovary, not a fetal mound. Then proceed downward with the left horn to see its structures. Then reach the bifurcation of the two horns. And I have to choose one of two ways. Either to continue, but I have to direct my body. Then I hold the right of a horn, and in this manner, till the end. And at the end of the right horn, I start to hold the right ovary. You see its structure here, with also hand into the sublumbar region, and you see the structures of the ovary inside and so on. And by this manner, I forget the two ovaries, the two uterines. The easy method is that you calculate the left side by the right hand, and you finish, then you introduce your left hand to palpate the right side. And this is somewhat easier, but it means that you have to conclude or introduce your two hands one after the other. So, palpation of the nerve get to this game very easy, and you must call fear and not manipulate, because the male rectum is very smooth, very delicate, and any abrasions may make kidney infection. And so you have to very gently in palpation. You introduce your hand in the sublumbar region, then you start to palpate the left ovary by your right hand. That's the state. Be sure that it is the left ovary because of its kidney shape and see the pressure in the same. And you can pull it somewhat from this place. Be sure that it is not a fecal ball that you are doing. Then you proceed downward to palpate the left horn till the bifurcation. So you have to turn your body to palpate the right horn in this manner by the flat fingers and not hard manipulation. Then till you reach the right ovary. Also handed in the sublumbar region, you start to estimate its size, the contents of the ovary. This one may 2 months of pregnancy, you notice the swelling here in the right horn near the bifurcation. This is in the size of a tennis ball. So the palpation and the palpation, the diagnosis of pregnancy in the male is done in the same manner that I palpate the left ovary by my right hand, proceed downward to see the left form, then at bifurcation, start to turn my body. Here there is swelling and there is fluctuation. You feel this fluctuation. Please don't do what we call it hit and miss slip as in cattle. This is wrong, my mistake, and may disturb the pregnancy. Only you palpate very gently this swelling, and you can feel the palpation, fluctuation of the fetal fluid. And there is asymmetry between the right horn and left horn. Then you proceed forward or upward in the right ovary, and here this maintained focus nutrient is present here in the ovulation fossa or ovulation depression. So this animal or this mare is pregnant in 2 months of pregnancy. Notice the fluctuation here near the ovulation fossa.